Because still quite a lot of people have the impression that every current that moves into a system flows back to ground. Why do we have this impression? I think this is very important because to talk about this a little bit before we are going further. When you're drawing a schematic, so I don't know how you are drawing a schematic. So suppose you are a designer of an electronic system, and the first thing that you are doing is making a concept. You say you need a microcontroller, a power amplifier, an analog to digital converter, so quite a lot of ICs. And then you are starting with the schematic. Maybe based on a schematic, you're doing some simulations. So let's start with the schematic. So you have maybe somehow here an IC. There is another IC. We have some bipolar transistors or some whatever MOS transistors. Then we are connecting somewhere our transistor, whatever it looks like. Or there is a connection from this IC down there to that IC. So there is current flowing from this output here into the input. And here is our ground pin. Here is our power supply. Maybe here I have, there's also the ground symbol. So thing is clear, so somehow in this way you're drawing your schematic, isn't it? Yeah, and just by drawing the schematic in this way, we very often get the impression, especially when we are operating this system, that current flows here from VDD into the microchip, then here out at the output, because we are driving some signals from this IC to that IC. So the current flows here into this IC. And your current has to flow back to the source where it's coming from. Where is it flowing back? Oh, there is a ground pin. Clear, the current flows to ground, and from ground it somehow flows back. So this is very often the impression that engineers have when they are designing schematics. And this is the somewhat stupid way how we are designing schematics, because we are just designing the path where the current is flowing from one IC to the other IC. But usually we are not drawing in the schematic the path where the current is flowing back. Because we suppose that the current is flowing to ground anyway, and it's in ground. So we do not care where the current then is flowing. And this is one of the biggest mistakes that we can do. Because, as I said, every current that flows here has to come back, and it's not always the case that the current goes back by ground. Especially high frequency currents, they go back by the path of the least impedance. And the least impedance might not be the path over ground, because ground can have a very big loop area coming back then to the IC. So there might be some other ways, for example, that the current that flows here into the pin might flow back out of an whatever output pin when the output pin is connected to zero potential, and then back to this IC if this loop area is then smaller. So it's not, so the message behind this, it's not always the ground where all the current is summarizing and flowing down. So maybe it's not always the ground pin which is the best location to characterize the electromagnetic emission.